All right, this is going to be part two of the Master Grade Skygrasper and Ampac. So I'm going to show off the combinations with the Skygrasper that I have. Now, initially they give you this. It's an adapter piece. It doesn't really work with the normal Striker packs. You don't need it, I should say. It just plugs into the back. I would assume it's for ones that are too big, they got too much stuff going on, and you need the extra backing, maybe. I have it, but I haven't tried it. The Iwashi? Not the, is it? The Otori. It might need that. Maybe the IWSP pack. I don't know. Maybe the other one, the Dragamo Akatsuki Shiranui pack, maybe? The Dragon one? I don't know. But yeah, you have an adapter. But so far none of the packs need this, so, and it doesn't actually connect to the Strike, because it's molded specifically for the Skygrasper. Now you also have parts to add on the sword and the launcher pack. This is for the sword pack. Basically, you just take it, you put the armor on it, and you clip it on here. When I get the sword pack, it will be eventually. I will show it off. But until then, I can show off the launcher pack. So, well, the launcher pack, the backpack piece, you just plug it in. And interesting enough, they give you an extra connector. Now, this one is the new connector. The old one is all articulated, has all the joints on it. This one has some swivels, but this whole part here is fused together, which definitely helps so you don't have to worry about it drooping a lot. It will droop, unfortunately, because it's heavy and very big. First things, I think I'll put the shoulder pack on. Now this thing, you have a couple extra pieces of this part here, and this part here. So first thing, you have to unplug the Gatling piece. And then take this new piece and feed it through here, and then peg it in like that. And then this part, oopsie, this part here, which connects to the shoulder of the Strike, is replaced by this new piece. Then it just pegs right back in like that. Then you peg that into the new piece, and we'll peg in the and that chain for the ammo. And they just kind of have those kind of up like that. And then it'll peg, because now you have the new peg holes. And now it'll all peg together. And so there that is, mounted on the side. And then using the new arm connector, we're just gonna peg it in. Now unfortunately you can't have this on the ground. It's way too big. But if you use the stand, you can easily have it in the air, but it still droops. Not much you can really do about it. Maybe, because like I said, parts are on swivels, you might be able to kind of twist things around, but it still doesn't matter. It's so heavy. So you can display it on the stand, but it's going to be like that. Which, as long as you can do it, I don't mind, because it's not going to be displayed with it. This is going to go onto the Strike. Now, actually, let's get that unpegged from get there. Oops. Well, whatever. This is a very solid connection. And let's get this off. And I'm going to show it with, just so you can tell, it does work with other packs. I'm going to show it with the Iwashi pack from the Dragamomoko Akatsuki. And it works very well. This is actually what I'm going to display it with. I'm going to display it on the stand with your washi pack, because that looks really, really good. I like that. You got missiles, you got cannons, and it will stand. That is cool. I really like that. Yeah, it's getting displayed with that pack, because I had that pack in a box, because I had nowhere to put it. But now I do. I don't like having extra packs not being utilized, so that's cool. And that's basically everything for the Skygrasper. Now the Strike, or the Dragamomoko Strike, it can do a few things now. Now I've attached the backpack, and you still extend the back piece. Now this part is a little loose. It'll stay on, but when I pull it, it pulls apart, so I suggest you pull it from the black piece, pull it out. And they do give you the two adapters, just like with the normal Bandai kit. to extend, so you can peg in the arms with the sword and the launcher. And you also get the energy canisters for the perfect strike. And they do come out, if you want. And everything is nice and secure. Now, I was hoping that for the launcher pack, I would be able to use this arm, the new one. That's all, like, connected together here. Unfortunately, the connector piece right here that they give you is a little too small, and it actually stressed the plastic when I tried to force it in. So, gonna have to use the, fully articulate one. Which, initially, I would have been upset about, but, because we have the new holding hands with the pegs, I can actually peg it into the hand without a problem, and it should be fine. So, let's remove that piece for the Sky Grasper, and attach the one for the strike, like that, and connect that back together. That's a little loose, gotta make sure that's connected. There we go. So we'll plug it onto the side here. Like that. And then we'll take the articulate arm right here. Where is the peg? There it is. Now is it that side? I think it's that side. Peg that there. And then peg that into the hole on the Sky Grasper. I mean, the alpac. And there we have it. There is almost, we'll call it semi-perfect strike. So, yeah, one more kit, and I will have a Master Grade perfect strike. Oh, and I have to add, because I forgot in the last video, that with Sky Grasper, if you want to have it with a launcher pack or a sword pack or the ill pack, they give you different color plates. Because, as we all know, the Sky Grasper has a lot of blue on it. Well, they give you the red plate, just like the Sword Strike would, the Dragon Momoko would have the red armor to make it look like kind of like the Impulse, the Sword Impulse. And this was the green, which would work for the launcher pack. And so, you can recolor your Sky Grasper to match whatever pack you have on it. Of course, you have to take the whole thing apart in order to switch the plates all the time, which is why I didn't do it. But it's cool that they give you all three color plates, blue, red, and green, depending on what pack you have. So that is pretty cool. I really like that. So, let's just finish off with these two together, because it is kind of like a set. So, I think the Masquerade Sky Grasper is really awesome. You get an upscaled version of the real grade, which is a good kit. And I think it's a little better, because it's bigger, obviously. You have a improved ale pack, which is way better than the original. And you get the adapter pieces, so you can connect the other packs from Dragon Momoko to make a perfect strike. I did try to connect the adapter pieces of the round connectors onto the ale pack here, and it wouldn't fit. They're a little too loose, but the band I'm pretty sure comes with those anyway, so that should be okay. I don't know if it'll work, if those adapters would work with these ball joints, but, if you got the Dragon Momoko Strike anyways, you don't really need it. This is definitely for a third-party perfect strike. So if you want to pick the Sky Grasper up, click the link below to go to Gundam Central, and I'll see you in the next review.